Sorry to keep you waiting, but we were just finishing off with the meeting of the SEC. Oh, you can come here. We'll start?
Yes, you are starting?
You say whether.
Yeah.
Just one moment, that MD JTDC, Sri Nikhil Desai is joining us, one moment.
It's already.
Let him join.
All right, that's what I thought, that very good evening to all of you. Today we have 29 new cases, 22 of them are linked to Mangu Hills. We have 5 positive cases of travelers by road, 4 from Maharashtra and 1 from Karnataka, and of 2 travelers from train, 1 from Aurangabad and 1 from Delhi. Our number of active cases now is 293. 292 is what my team has given me. Is there a discrepancy with yesterday's data? I'll check that. I'll come back to that when tourism department is talking. I'll confirm on that number. Samples which were sent for the testing today are 1,828. We received 1,700 results and 1,089 results are awaited. Today we had an inspection of Mangu Hills. It was led by our chief secretary. Chief Secretary Sir is accompanied by our IGP as well as myself and Collector North. The Deputy Collector and the local administration team was also there. We visited Mangu Hill, we inspected the arrangements made by the district administration as well as the police to maintain the containment zone, and we also inspected the facilities made for the OPD services for the public of Mangu. We interacted with persons from Mangu Hill and we listened to a couple of suggestions and feedback that they had. For instance, just to share with you, they wanted extension of the OPD hours. So as of now, we were doing the OPD for 2 hours. So immediately upon receiving their request, the Chief Secretary has directed that we will have OPD from for 3 hours. Actually, we will start at 10 o'clock and take it on till 1 o'clock. Even though we have been maintaining 2 hours, it has always spilled over to around 2 hours, 15 minutes or 2.5 hours. But yes, since there is a felt need by the public of Mangu that we need to extend the OPD hours, we will be extending the hours from tomorrow onwards. There were also requests that certain medicines need to be supplied to the people for their regular routine medication. So we have asked them, the volunteers in the area are quite active. We have requested them to prepare a list and share it with the local administration, and we will be making the necessary provisions. We have with us today Mr. Menino D'Souza, who is our Director of Tourism, and Sri Nikhil Desai, who is our MDGTDC. I would request both of them to share with you regarding information about opening of hotel.
Good evening, everyone. In respect of hotels, as you are aware that hotels have been permitted to be opened by the central government ministry's guidelines. But what we have done is in the state that all hotels who are ready to comply to the guidelines, they have to actually apply to the Department of Tourism, and after we see that they are compliant to all these guidelines and all, we will permit them. So the protocol, the SOPs to be put in place will be deciding after taking into account all the information on what we get from them. And we'll also ensure that they give a declaration that they comply to all this guidance from the central government. So as of now, I understand that we have opened up the website. We have received almost around 30 applications. So we will be scrutinizing them, and after the government takes a call on it, we will allow them to open the hotels depending on how they are compliant to all these guidelines.
Would you like to add something?
Basically, this will be online process. Already, we have informed the hotel industry to apply online, give their details, and then the director of tourism will take a decision. And then a final date will be given to them from where they can start operationalizing, subject to them meeting the guidelines. Because as you know, today, even if they open tomorrow, where are the tourists? That is the question in the minds of most hoteliers. Opening is, but they are also facing some problem in the form of manpower who have migrated. So some of them are not fully ready to start their operation as of now. So all these issues will be considered and the department will then authorize them. No sooner they authorize, one cutoff date will be given. That will be also communicated outside. But this is all subject to protocols being in place. Once government decides the protocols, only then things will be in place.
This is regarding to which hotel? You are talking about five star or restaurants or whatever.
No,
because some of the restaurants have already started.
See, what is happening is for us hotels, we always speak about hotels. The hotels are registered with the department.
Room.
I think for
with
food,
rooms.
Yeah. And restaurants are actually a separate issue where I think food and drugs department.
Yes, for restaurants, already the collectors have issued orders and they have been reiterated by our director of food and drug administration. So I think there is clarity regarding restaurants. Meghna ji, would you like to share? Today my colleague Sanjay is not here with us, so I will request our director of information and publicity, Shrimati Meghna Shikankar, to share some of the figures with you.
As per in Goyan, 21,141 lok aile. आणि गोव्यातल्या बाहेर बसणाऱ्या लोकांचा नंबर असा 110,348. आरोग्य सेतू ॲप 299,000 लोकांनी डाउनलोड केला असा, जो सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंटान डिझाईन केला तो ॲप. जसे जसं लोकांचा डिमांड येता स्टँडर्ड लेबररचो, तसे तसे फुडले ट्रेन सगळे शेड्यूल जातात.
Before that, the figure is 292, number of active cases. Yesterday it was 263 plus 29, 292. Yes.
Yeah. And how many from Mangur?
Mangur breakup, I mentioned 22, right?
Yeah.
Just a moment. I'll just cross-check in with you. Yes, 22 from Mangur. Yes. Linked to Mangur Hills. Yes.
Ma'am, first question. Today when you all went there, the people from the locality, they gherao, you all asking about the essential supplies and all those things?
Absolutely not. There was no gherao at all.
Nothing.
We had an interaction with the public, as I mentioned to you. And we did listen to their grievances.
So they complained about the essential commodities.
Yes.
And other
now that I wouldn't even term it as a complaint, because what they wanted were the shops to open up. Now naturally in a containment zone we cannot have the grocery shops opening. And we told them that whatever requirement they have, they should note it down and hand it over to the local administration. The collector assured that by 4 o'clock the rations would reach there. At 4 sharp the rations reached. I understand that some people refused to take the rations. So whatever are their needs, their ration needs, their daily commodities, all of that is being taken care of. But their demand was that the shop should be allowed to function. Now, and this was in the buffer zone, not exactly in the containment zone. It was within Mangurin, but within the buffer zone. We didn't find any logic in accepting that request that the shop should be open. We conveyed to them that it is not at all something that can be agreed upon. But the collector assured them that the rations would be available to them by 4 p.m. And at 4 p.m. sharp, the rations have been delivered. Some people have taken them, some people have not taken them.
Okay, ma'am. Second question is that that doctor initially who had tested the negative is tested positive today. And second thing, the complaints that that he had prescribed them allopathic medicine. He is a homeopathic medicine. Is any action being initiated against him?
You're right about the first aspect that you mentioned, that he has been tested positive today. He was in our quarantine ever since the first day when we took him for the test, and he and his family were in our quarantine facility. We wanted to repeat his test, that is why we repeated it today and we found him positive. Now, regarding action, there is an inquiry, as Honorable CM had also mentioned yesterday, there is an inquiry underway and we will be taking necessary action accordingly.
Are there questions on tourism? When you say the guidelines,
do you want to explain what are these guidelines? These guidelines are basically health and hygiene guidelines which Ministry of Health has given to all India, not only to us only. So wherever outside the containment zones where hotels have been permitted, these guidelines are very good.
Do you have a deadline by when all the hotels have to come?
No, in fact, in that application where they have applied to us, we have told them, they themselves have to give us a date when they are ready. So government will decide from the state side when to actually allow them to open, and if we are satisfied that we can permit them and as per the guidelines they are really compliant, then we can allow them.
And are you expecting any tourists this season?
Of course. What do you say at this time?
Yeah.
You feel that domestic tourists, I feel, definitely will try to come.
Yeah, but their staff, whoever the hotels, if they get it from the other states, how would you consider again quarantine them and this testing?
You mean to say if somebody who interacts with people
yeah,
who come from outside?
Yeah, most of the staff is from outside. In the hotel.
That's right.
Yeah. And if they come and
but then those are not the workers who are coming and going. They are workers who will be staying put here in Goa.
Yeah.
So at the time of entry, are you talking about they are already here or they are going to come from
abroad?
They
are already gone.
Already here, right?
Most of them
they have gone back, you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll take care of them as per the protocol when they come back. We have a protocol naturally for entry into the state, so we'll take care of it according to that.
Ma'am, with the present scenario, with the number of increasing cases, and do you think so in areas like Kalangut, where there are a huge number of hotels, and these hotels are booked and so many passengers come, then it won't get overcrowded and some serious issues?
You see, all necessary precautions as per the ministry's guidelines will be put in place, and the decision to allow tourists or allow passenger traffic through the country has already been made in a sense by the Ministry of Home Affairs, and the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has issued guidelines for the same. So we will be following all of that, and then of course it is something that will be an evolving situation which we will watch.
What are the precautions that you would take as far as hotels are concerned?
No, that whatever the SOP is to be there, that will decide after some time. At the moment, we are just taking them application from the hotels and seeing the readiness for starting the hotel. So, those protocols will be ready in place.
We have 30 applications.
At the moment, I think as of now, we have 30 applications.
But what is the timeline you are looking at for restarting
the tourism? In fact, as per the guidelines now, they are actually. Allowed to, but what is happening is that state has to be ensure that they are also following these guidelines, the SOPs read in place are actually there or not. So all these things have to be verified. And even the state will be, whether the state is ready or not, that the state will decide when to allow them to.
Will you be inspecting the individual premises of each hotel to ensure compliance? Anything along those lines?
See, we will get all the details now. It is not possible to inspect every hotel and then allow. So we will definitely be doing random checks.
What exactly?
SOP is mentioned that whether the hotel has sanitation facility, how will be they looking at a suspect, suppose if a patient develops certain symptoms, then what are the procedures to be followed? Suppose then what is the norms of social distancing they have to follow? All these guidelines have come from Ministry of Tourism. State will modify it, make it a little bit more, we can make it more tougher than what the MOT has specified. So all those issues are being will be deliberated, finalized by government, and then a date will be given. Fact that we have opened the application process does not mean we will allow them randomly anytime like next week or so. That is a call government has to take. Right now we are ascertaining their preparedness, whether you all are ready or not ready. So we know in a staggered manner how you can open things up. Right now everything is closed, and because of that the state is going through a massive financial crunch. So this decision will have to be taken by government. We will be giving them the data that these are the hotels who are ready, these are not ready. Some of them say that they will open in July, August, September. We will get all that data and place facts before government. Then the government has to take a call from when to allow them, depending on the other circumstances. Like as you say, the COVID numbers, everything, that government will decide and then fix a cutoff date. It does not imply that we have started, so now Goa is opening hotels. Certainly that is not the case. We'll get everything analyzed and then place the fact before government. Government will then take a call as to when to allow them to open.
With this, you must have to put in place also, things how will it work out, because when the guest and our tourist comes, what about beaches? Then other activities, how do you take care of that?
No, that will be there. I mean, if whatever protocol is there for any other.
You think they will follow it?
They have to follow. What do you mean by that?
I'm saying as far as social distancing.
That will be a process being monitored by several authorities, the local administration, the police, the tourism department. There will be many people to maintain a watch and to monitor. So it will be our responsibility to ensure that the protocol as we are notifying is followed.
And is it fair enough at this point where...
I don't think there's any point discussing it further. It's already been well explained.
No, because...
Let us remember that in Europe, some of the worst affected countries have started developing protocols and they have started fixing dates for things to open up. See, it cannot, and the situation is evolving rapidly. So as the situation evolves, the government is framing up its response. While dealing with the pandemic, it is also that we have to also look at the livelihoods. And as you know, tourism being the mainstay of our economy, it has been severely hampered. Now with people's jobs being lost, expansion plans put on hold, it is going to affect us hard. So we cannot, there cannot be a situation where there is a status quo without any light at the end of the tunnel. So what I am saying is, it is not that we are saying that it will open after 5 days or 10 days. All these factors will be put up before the government. Government will evaluate all other circumstances and then take an appropriate decision by giving due consideration to the safety of the public of Goa. It is not that doors will be opened, you come, thousands and lakhs of tourists will come on the beaches. That is certainly not the case. It will be a phased opening, but I cannot speak more on that because now we are getting data and then that is the domain of the government. But I am sure all these things will be on everybody's consideration. And
can you just give us the breakup of all the cases around Goa, because people have started locking down the villages. And as of now, it was some people coming from this Keri checkpost and all have been stopped at the point, and they are not being allowed. The vehicles are not allowed.
If you ask me a specific question about a particular area, I'd be in a position to answer. I don't have the breakup as of now with me.
Well,
it is true that
tomorrow at least,
okay,
if we can get.
It is true that some villages have declared a sort of self-imposed lockdown.
Yeah.
At Keri, all measures have been taken to ensure that interstate movement is not hampered because of the local decisions or local strategies. But I don't have the breakup as of now.
Yeah,
immediately.
At least if you could give us.
Yes.
I just want to know the perspective that you had for the SOB that was announced yesterday, and also there are a lot of people who are afraid now that the mandatory testing has been removed. So how do you see it?
I don't think there's any concern the required, because the SOP is being changed. What we are saying is that there will be a mandatory 14-day home quarantine. For those people who don't have the facility for such a home quarantine because of their particular circumstances, they can opt for an institutional paid quarantine. Now, the way we see it, this is a sustainable and a strategic move that we are making, because we need to have a very focused approach towards testing. The more samples we keep taking from everyone who comes across the borders, we are somewhere losing focus on the areas within Goa where we need to look at very specifically. Mangor Hill is a case in point. You already know that we are constantly screening the people. Even today, our OPD has screened over 200-250 people. We have to take samples of the people who are falling in the 5 high-risk categories that I mentioned already yesterday and day before, in fact. And similarly, there are other focal points where we need to strategize, and we need to ensure that there is no outbreak as such. We need to see that the cases which are being suspected are tested on time, the results are available on time. So I think a very focused approach is required from now on. And the more we load our labs with samples drawn from each and everyone who's entering into the state, the less we will be able to do a focused mitigation of coronavirus in our state. That is why we have proposed the change in the SOP, but that doesn't mean that therefore we are being less cautious or that we are lowering our guard, because we are in fact saying that everybody has to undergo a 14-day mandatory home quarantine. Failing, if you have any problem in doing that because of your circumstances, you can opt for an institutional paid quarantine. Or for some reason, for official purposes, for professional reasons, if you feel that you have to go back to your workplace sooner, you have the option of coming to us, paying and getting your test done. You can offer it even when you're coming. So this is the logic behind the SOP, if you ask me.
On that, has the new machine that is brought at GMC, has that been installed? Has the calibration
completed? The calibration is completed. We have the last step of getting the reagents. The reagents have been shipped from Mumbai. We are expecting their arrival any time today or tomorrow. As soon as we get the reagents, we are ready to go. The calibration is done. The team is trained. We are all set.
With that machine becoming operational, how many tests are you expected to do?
456 when that machine is at top capacity. It will take us a few days to reach that capacity, because every time we get a new machine, that machine takes time. Initially, it takes more time than these 456 tests that I'm talking about. It will take around 3 to 4 days for us to get that optimum result of 456.
RT-PCR.
RT-PCR, yes.
Also, these 22 cases that came positive.
Yes.
Are you seeing any, is there some sort of trend that you're seeing? Is there an increase in the radius or the perimeter has extended? And are you also seeing anything about how the infection might have spread to this on this date, that is, from 1st to 10th, or sorry,
8th. Yes.
How are you seeing those?
So our strategy in Mangur has been to first focus on the on the immediate location where we found the first positive cases. That became our point from where we then arrived at a radius. So we then demarcated a containment zone and a buffer zone. So our first step was to take the samples of all the people in that immediate vicinity, which we did on day one itself. Then we expanded slowly, as you have rightly mentioned, we have been expanding our perimeter. Now every day we have people coming to our OPD. They have several complaints. Not all of them are in any way related to corona. Some of them are. Definitely there are concerns about whether they have temperature. They just want to check their temperature. They want to get their child's temperature checked. There are some people who are chronic patients of some or the other ailment. They want to be checked. But also, yes, there is a group of people whom we are targeting. They are the high-risk population, as we call it. About 65 years, below 5 years of age, pregnant women, comorbid conditions, symptomatic. In that category, we are ensuring that we take the samples. So we are observing definitely that I wouldn't prematurely say that the graph is coming down or anything. I will not comment on that. But in terms of absolute numbers, yes, the more we are panning out in the locality, we do observe that the numbers are coming down slightly. Having said that, Mangur remains an area of high concern for us. And the health of the people over there, especially of the high-risk category, is our primary concern today. The total number of tests?
Samples.
You see, initially we took around, over the past 3 to 4 days, initially we took 1,000 samples. And then every day we have been adding around 40 to 50 to that number. So today I would say that we would be somewhere around the number of 1,300, 1,350. These are the samples taken.
Does this fresh 22 cases at Mangur also include health workers?
Let me just clarify there. These 22 cases are not from Mangur. They are linked to Mangur. Yes, it includes the healthcare workers because the healthcare workers are all those who worked in the Mangur area.
So you'll be able to give us the breakup tomorrow.
Of what?
Of the cases
throughout.
From the other area.
You want to know exactly which location the cases are found, right? Correct.
So far, no community transmission, no, today.
Again and again,
cases
I.
Cases are found in Vasco also.
Yes. You see, just because a case is found in a particular new location doesn't mean that it is community transmission. As long as you can link it to an existing case, it is not community transmission as per the definition of MOHFW. What we are seeing in local Mangur Hill is a local outbreak. So that area is why we have declared it as a containment zone, because there is a local outbreak within it.
And have you shifted all your asymptomatic patients to...
Yes. As we speak, we have around 68 patients who are there. And I wouldn't even call them patients, 68 positive cases who are there at SDH Shiroda. In fact, I forgot to mention that we also visited SDH Shiroda today and we interacted with the team of the doctors who are there, the staff. The patients seem to be pretty fine over there and we ensured that there are enough arrangements for their food, for their regular medical checkups. There was a need for an ambulance to be put there that has immediately been tied up. The staff required a place to stay. The collector has already made arrangements for that. So we had also visited SDH Shiroda, which is our COVID care center now. And in fact, the capacity is almost as good as 180 to 200 beds over there. Right now, they have around 70 operational beds, but they are getting more beds. There is enough space. It is actually a pretty new property. It's a new construction and we were happy to see that we have a very dedicated and motivated young team of doctors who are leading the effort there. And we hope that they will be able to do as good a job as our team at the COVID hospital.
How many migrants are there to leave Goa now? Any list is there?
They are the list. Yeah. The team which is handling the migrant standard laborers are preparing the list of how many are left and still want to go to their hometown.
So then no one is there, nobody is there in there. The person who wants to go, list is not still made.
It is being made.
Because we have seen today in the Azad Maidan, 15 people were standing around there. So we had a big issue with them. So they said nobody has bothered to check, to give them food also, nothing. They're lying down there in Azad Maidan.
That would not be correct to say because our shelter homes are providing food and then messages are going to each one who had registered with us earlier.
Because they were in the shelter home in a youth hostel. So they have been taken out from there. They have sent out and then they have sent to Pede. So from Pede also they have been kicked out and they said, you go.
Yes. it is not that we have kicked out anybody. See, the arrangement is made in some other shelter home. It is not viable for running a shelter home with 5 or 10 people. So another arrangement is made. That's not correct to say that we have kicked out.
But they have given us bite on this on the front of
you
the.
You could have advised them.
We are even the SP had come there now. They have taken them.
So they would take a call.
Yes, I'm sure that since the police has come to know about these cases, they'll be taken care of.
Ma'am, what about this patient who fled from Goa after being found positive or something like that?
I have no information about this case that you're mentioning. I really don't know where you always find information about these odd cases here and there. Honestly, I have no idea about any. No, positive patient, you mean to say? Impossible. Impossible. Patient, the moment they are found to be positive, we take them to our COVID hospital or our COVID care center. And really, the arrangements in either of these places is not of the situation that people will run away from there. The best care is being provided to them. And I say that with 100% confidence, that the very best care is being provided to both our symptomatic patients at COVID care hospital, as well as our asymptomatic persons at the at COVID hospital, as well as our asymptomatic persons at the COVID care center. Thank you.